power well is drilled on LAN. Step number 1. Digging a cellar. On land, a majority of wells begin with digging a cellar from 3 to 15 feet in depth. The purpose of a cellar is to align the production Christmas tree at ground level, providing easier access to the valves, chokes, and other equipment. Step 2, running a conductor pipe. The first string of pipe used in a well is called the conductor pipe, or dry pipe. The pipe is usually 30 to 36 inches in diameter. A large diameter hole is drilled to a specified depth, usually 1 or 200 feet, and the pipe is driven into the ground. Step 3, connecting the blowout preventer. Step 3, connecting the blowout preventer. An adaptive flange, or drilling flange, is welded to the conductor pipe to connect a diverter system or a blowout preventer system to control well head pressure. Step 4, running the surface pipe. A hole is drilled for the well's first string of pipe, the surface pipe, and the pipe is run in the hole. There may be several strings of pipe in a well. Each run to a different depth. The number of strings is determined by the number of zones being drilled through. These can include freshwater, saltwater, and potential production zones. Each zone is isolated, or cased off until it is to be produced. Step 5, connecting the surface pipe. The surface pipe is cemented in place back to the surface. This holds the pipe in place and seals off the zone. A cement plug is left in the pipe so that the box system may be disconnected safely. The blowout preventer is then removed from the adapter flange. Step 6, cutting the conductor pipe and surface casing. The surface pipe that drains the adapter flange, or drilling flange, is cut off. And both the conductor pipe and the surface casing are cut at the proper height to allow the top of the completed wellhead to be at ground level. Step 7, installing the casing head housing and base plate. The casing head housing is welded in place on the inside diameter and the outside diameter of the surface casing. The housing is then tested to assure there are no leak paths in the welds. Step 8, installing the blowout preventer system. The blowout preventer system is installed above the casing head housing and then tested. To test the blowout preventer system, the test plug is made up of the drill string and lowered through the box system onto the casing head bowl. The pressure is applied from above the plug to test the blowout preventer system. Step 9, installing the casing head wear bushing. A wear bushing is installed to protect the interior of the casing head from damage by drilling equipment. Step 10, installing the intermediate string. A hole is drilled for the intermediate string and the casing is run in the hole and cemented in place. A cement plug is left in the intermediate casing, just as it was in the surface casing. Step 11. Installing the casing hanger and casing spool. The intermediate casing is suspended from the block above the rig floor, the bob is picked up, and the casing hanger is installed on top of the casing head. Holes are cut in the casing to allow the drilling fluids to drain out of the casing riser. When the fluid has drained, the casing is cut off to the appropriate height and the casing spool is installed. Step 12. Installing the blowout preventer system. The blowout preventer system is installed above the casing spool and then tested. To test the blowout preventer system, the test plug is made up of a drill string and lowered through the blowout preventer system onto the casing head bowl. The pressure is applied from above the plug to test the blowout preventer system. Step 13, installing wear bushing. The wear bushing running tool is made up of the drill string and the wear bushing installed on the running tool. The wear bushing is then lowered through the bob system until it rests in the casing spool bowl, then is locked into place. The running tool is removed and drilling resumes. Step 14, running the production casing string. The production casing string is usually run to the total depth of the well. A hole is drilled for the production casing and the casing is run in the hole and cemented into place. A cement plug is left in the production casing, as in the previous step. Step 15. Installing the casing hanger and tubing spool. The production casing is suspended from the elevators at the rig floor, the blowout preventer is picked up, and the production casing hanger is installed in the same way as the previous casing hanger. The tubing spool is installed in the same way as the casing spool. After the spool has been installed, the seals and connections are tested, and the blowout preventer system is reinstalled. Step 16, running the production tubing. The production tubing is installed inside the production casing. Unlike casing, the production tubing is not cemented in the well, so it may be removed later, if necessary. Step Step 17. Installing the downhole packer assembly. The downhole packer assembly, a type of seal assembly, is run and installed in the production casing to seal the reservoir from all strings of pipe, except the production tubing. Step 18. Installing the tubing hanger. The tubing hanger is installed on the tubing at the rig floor, then lowered into the bowl of the tubing spool. The packer seals are tested, and a back pressure valve is installed in the tubing hanger so that the blowout preventer can be removed safely. After the valve has been installed, the blowout preventer is removed. Step 19. Installing the Christmas tree. The production Christmas tree, sometimes called the flow assembly, controls the flow of the well. It is made up of a seal flange, or tube and paired adapter, a series of valves, and a choke. The valves are stacked vertically and horizontally to provide backup should a valve fail. Each Christmas tree has at least one actuated surface safety valve to shut down the well in an emergency and prevent damage to equipment downstream. The Christmas tree is connected to a flow line, which transports the well's fluid or gas.
This bell icon so you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.